Hi guys, and welcome to yet another very exciting Adobe Illustrator tutorial. And in this tutorial, we are going to talk about this link image and the pen that is used with it. In the last tutorial, you learned how to place a link image in your Adobe Illustrator document and what was the benefit of it and the main benefit was that it did not change your document size because it just creates a link to the original source. So, to bring up its panel, go to Windows and come here now where it says links. You click it, this sort of image or panel opens up with these options blanked because I have not selected the file, but if I select it, it upgrades and gives me all these infos. If it's not open showing, click on this triangle icon and it will show up. First of all, it's the name of the document that appears, then it tells you this document or the format of it, whether it's a PhD, Photoshop file, InDesign or any other application file. It tells you that information, color, space, which is important, whether it is RGB, CMYK or something else, or whatever color scheme it has, it shows you there, the location on your hard disk or maybe on the network. If you are working in your office or which hard drive in the network it is present, all those details are given here. If you click it, it will take you to their place. PPI means pixel rate. So what sort of pixels are being used here, in what proportion, dimension. As I told you in the previous tutorial, the document is very high, but the space I allotted for it is very small. That's why some distortion and the picture is not clearly showing and it's a little bit blur or, you know, grainy type of a picture. So scale, it shows size, it shows how many bytes it has. You know, it's 79 MB, which is for an image file which is a little bit more than anyone would like, you know. So that's the benefit of this linked images, that it does not increase the actual document size unless you want to print or save another copy of it, you know. So that's how it's used here. When what is created and modified, those options are also gone. Now these are some other options here. The first one is relink to the CC library. It can relink it to library, and this one option, if you click it, if you want to relink it and if some, for some reason the link has been broken, you can of course relink to the original. In here, this option, if your document for example is made like this and you lost track of the linked image where it was, if you click on this, it will bring you back to the link image that which one is selected. And this option, of course, is, if you remember the last tutorial, that when I updated the document or the image in the Photoshop application, then it took a little bit of time before it was updated in the Adobe Illustrator. If it does not update automatically, then click on this option and it will update it. The last option, this one, is edit the original, that it will not edit only the link that has been established or placed here, but will edit the original that was present in the source or the hard drive, wherever it is, it's going to edit the original copy. You can also access this panel by clicking this linked file name, and it also gives you these options. Or if you are looking for these five, you know, commands, then you can just click on the name of the linked image and it also gives you those options to do. So that's what link panel is, and that's what it's useful. It gives you useful information and also few commands, how to use them. So with that said, I take my leave from you guys and hope that you like this tutorial and hope to see you in the next one.